This right here is the 2013 13-inch MacBook Pro, and while it may be a decade old, Apple's design with the screen and the aluminum body have really made it stand up against the test of time. But now that we're going into 2024, I wonder how well does this thing hold up? I'm going to be doing a few tests, first of all, of how well it loads things, how well it does web browsing, can it play games like Minecraft maybe, and then also see what the battery life is like at the end. First test we're going to do here is a little boot up test. So I'm going to press the power button and the start button, and I'm going to see how long this thing takes to boot up. All right, so it took about 30 seconds to boot up. I'm going to log in, and I'm going to see how long it takes to log in, as well as how fast it will be at loading some apps. So I'm going to first try launching like Safari, Messages, the Notes app, maybe Apple TV, the App Store. It's actually handling this pretty well. I'm going to try switching between them. I'm try me going to Google here. I know Google takes up a lot of bandwidth. So it's actually healing things pretty well. I don't see it really lagging at all. As you can see, I'm scrolling here. Things are loading. I can click on stuff, and it's pretty snappy, even with a few apps open. Just because I'm curious, I'm going to try launching Safari and just see how long it takes to load. And it literally takes about a second. So that's really good. What I'm going to do now is do some workflow tests. So we're in Google Docs. I'm going to try doing a little typing test here. Handled that typing test really well. I didn't notice any type of lag. I'm going to try doing a copy and paste and seeing if it is kind of laggy there. And it handled that really well, which is pretty nice. Another thing I want to do here now that we're in Safari is try loading multiple tabs. So I'm going to load apple.com, and things on apple.com load really well. I'm going to try opening up Facebook, X. And then why not? We'll just do TripAdvisor too. And I'm switching between these tabs here, and things are loading super well. We know that it handles websites really well, but let's try going to YouTube and seeing how well it can play videos. So I honestly can't show you this video because of copyright, but I can tell you that YouTube is loading really well in this. When you get to the bottom, it does kind of lag out a bit, just because it has to load all those thumbnails. But overall, I'm very impressed with this. Another web-based application that I want to try out is this online game called Crunker.io. I'm going to honestly play this in expert mode because I'm an expert. But anyways, I'm going to click play here. And I can tell you this is really laggy. Oh, you can just see the lag there. So maybe with online games like Crunker, it doesn't run really well. But also, too, maybe this web browser isn't updated to the latest version, which could affect things. And maybe it can run better in Chrome. But in Safari, it's not really handling it super well. So I'm downloading Minecraft right now because I know there's a lot of people out there who want to play Minecraft on this thing. I'm going to be doing a test here on the default settings. I got Minecraft all downloaded. I'm currently generating a new world. All right, so I just load in. So typically when you do load into a new Minecraft world, it is going to be pretty laggy. Right now, we're at 9, 8, 10 FPS. But I'm going to give it a few minutes here. I'm going to see how well things load once we've been in the world for a while. It's been about 2 minutes, and the frames are hovering around 15 to 20 frames per second. What I am going to try doing is I am going to try putting down the render distance and seeing if that makes a difference. So right now, I have the render distance set to 8 chunks. I'm going to exit out here. And it did go up a little bit. Now we're at like 20 to 25, oh, we're getting 30s there. But it's still not what I consider really playable, which is kind of disappointing because I know on the 2013 iMac, Minecraft runs pretty decent on. Right now I'm in the battery usage window, and when I started out this video originally, I was at about 60%, but I've been using it for about an hour and a half, and as I got into more heavier stuff like Crunker and playing and downloading Minecraft, it did start going down a bit quicker. So right now I'm at 25%, which kind of gives an idea, you know, if you use it for an hour and a half doing stuff like that, what it degrade as. But something I do want to mention of this though, is Apple advertises this laptop with 9 hours of web browsing for battery life. But because batteries age, the older and older they get, they hold less and less capacity. So this computer is at about 78% battery health. It's more likely that you're going to get, let's say, 7 to 8 hours of web browsing instead of the 9 that they originally advertised. A set is something to keep in mind if you are going to be using this and hoping it lasts you the whole day. You are going to have to bring a charger with you, and you are going to have to make sure like you charge it up all the way before you go into work. So that's just something to keep in mind with this. So overall, you probably have an idea by now of how this laptop performs. It's really good for web browsing. It's really good for online work and stuff like that. But if you are like a pro user, or you need to access stuff like for music production, video editing, photo editing, or like you use Microsoft Excel, this isn't really a great laptop for that. But I will say though, this laptop is very nice for somebody who is maybe in high school and just needs to use Google Docs, or like you're buying it for a kid or a grandparent. This is going to be a very nice laptop for them. That's kind of an overview. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. And if you want a more in-depth review on this, I'll leave that in the description as well as in a card up here if I can. Thank you all for watching.